going to turn it off? Turn it off?
Yes.
Punching harder.
Your prediction for this fight? Ruben just told me 8 rounds. What do you think?
Sounds about right.
Think about 8 rounds?
Sounds about right. I think he'll hurt him, say like in the 5th or 6th, and then he's going to keep on hurting him until the referee just stops it.
It's not easy being in a ring with Jose. He keeps coming and coming and throwing and throwing.
He's a really
high volume puncher.
High volume, exactly, yeah. He sets some traps and whenever he thinks it's time to go, he goes.
Keeps going, so there you have it. Great sparring today, Robert.
Hell yeah.
You're a punching machine, Jose. Keep going and going. Looks good. Work, 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 work. Chepe and Charles helping Jose. He's about to work out. Mitz, heavy bag, what next? Charles.
I'll probably bag work.
No, and then you guys put that,
I've seen Muay Thai fighters on purpose that their shin guards smell awful.
Yeah.
So when they kick the opponent in Muay Thai, they do it on purpose.
Man, that sanitizer smell.
Like,
it woke you up. Yeah.
And then with this, it's over 100 inside here.
It is, it is.
And sparring guys like that, you know, obviously it's gonna.
It's very high.
It's like a conditioning stunt.
Leo Ruiz, second after sparring Jose Ramirez. 6 rounds today with Leo. Coach Chepa in the house. He did good this weekend. Oh, you didn't see it. You got to see it. He did good.
No, I got to see it, man.
But he gave perfect instructions. He said the right things. How'd you know?
As soon as I got there, I figured out the game plan.
And what's his name? Jackson left you thinking a little bit too much about the fight. But once he got in there, some of the little videos that I saw, he looked like, I've been sparring Virgil, sparring Ramirez. He was ready. You know, Jackson, so he looked...
That's what I told everybody. Everybody asked me, how was Jackson looking in training camp? Look, everybody in our gym, it's really hard to get a guy that's going to look great because of the sparring they get, you know? It's just, you're never going to see a guy be really,
he's sparring
really
pound-for-pound fighters.
Exactly. You know?
Yeah, you can't be perfect every sparring session.
Yeah, exactly.
Sometimes one guy looks good on Monday, sometimes he looks... Yeah. The other guy looks better on Wednesday, true. Friday.
No, you're right.
Vamos, eh? Empezamos rápido. Tiempo.
Jose, it's your third camp for Viktor Postol. How many times have you watched him fight in the last 8 months?
Not many.
No?
Not many, actually, no. I'm a little different when it comes to studying my opponents. You know, I watch him once, twice, but and I probably watch him one more time on fight week. But I try not to focus too much on some of his past fights, you know.
In case he'll be different, yeah.
He's always different, so I don't want to get my mind. I don't want to spoil my mind thinking that he's going to fight a certain way or make the same mistakes he made and stuff like that, you know.
That's true.
Or even some fights where he looks good, you know. And I don't want to be emphasizing on what he does well, you know. I want to focus on what I got to bring to the table.
It's a big fight. We're excited. And hopefully everything goes well. You take care of business, and afterwards you have Josh Taylor,
Josh
you have
Taylor
Crawford.
For the Undisputed, yeah.
That would be sick. Undisputed.
Undisputed fight, yeah.
Right now I have you on my pound for pound list, but after you have those four belts, I don't want to hear anybody else say anything else, Jose.
I appreciate that.
A bunch of haters.
You know, it's okay, man. We gotta. You know, I'm in good spirits, man. I think I've been very blessed. I'm a very blessed person. Not just as a boxer, but I think as a person, I have a very loving family, and I have my own family of my own, and I don't wish nothing bad upon nobody, you know.
No, of course not.
And I appreciate all the fans supporting me, or even those supporting other fighters, because I think fighters deserve the support. So as long as they're supporting boxing, you know, that's you know, I'm happy with that, you know. That makes me happy.
I'm gonna tell you something funny. Alexis, how many times have I worked your corner?
Huh?
How many times have I worked your corner?
Twice. Twice already.
Tell Jose, what are you like the week before the fight when you're cutting weight? Are you easy to deal with? Are you fun? Are you chill? Or are you like, leave me alone?
I'm kind of like, leave me alone.
He's 12 days out and he's chilling, he's smiling.
But 5 week is just, I'm the same way. You know, I like to
give you space.
I don't have that type of energy to
to socialize.
You know, to be able to talk to people.
That's how I get too. I'm kind of like, wait, it's not
like,
even.
I run out of breath in the five weeks.
I don't want nobody calling me.
Yeah, I don't want
you don't want to see nobody smile.
What about people hitting you up for tickets? Hey, Jose, I need 3 tickets. What's up, Jose? I haven't talked to you in 2 years.
You know what I hate the most?
That doesn't happen to me no more. I contact my younger brother.
What time you fight?
Oh, I know.
Oh, what channel? What channel?
I figured it out.
Bro, what the fuck?
I just said ESPN Plus. I'm telling everybody. But that happens to you a lot too. Will you tell him?
It's not even because like I'm making weight. I just feel like, you know, you get
focused.
You're just like, I'm just trying to.
Yeah, it's a little bit of everything. You know, you're
just trying to play little shows, playing little games on my phone.
Elie, your mask is back, bro.
I do that on purpose. I'm making a statement. How do you know what's the front and what's the back?
You can pull it anyway.
Yeah.
As long as I have a mask on, that's what matters. Hey, you know, I saw a story in the news. How do you know if a mask is good or not? How do you test it? Do you know how?
How?
You light a match or a candle and you try to blow it out through the mask. If you could do it, the mask is bad. If you can't do it, the mask is good. True story. Try it. Let's see if the masks are good or not. Are you fighting on Jose's card? What weight?
160.
160, just like your weight? That's good. You're going to have a lot of sparring here.
Yes, sir.
Do you know who? It doesn't matter.
Some kid from Louisiana. I mentioned my knockout, man.
Have you ever been to Louisiana?
Yeah.
I want to go. I've never been.
Yeah, there's.
Did you eat crocodile when you were out there?
No, I was trying to. I heard it's spicy.
Have you ever eaten crocodile?
No.
Have you ever eaten crocodile? I think Mikey has. I don't know if it's spicy, it's the way they cook it.
No, I heard it's naturally spicy. No.
Yeah, but it's cool. But you're in a good mood too.
Me?
Yeah. You're not like mad or cutting weight. Don't talk to me, don't look at me.
I can make 160 easy.
Now you say that. How old are you?
Huh?
19, 20?
24.
Well, you look young. He looks young for 24. I thought he's like 19. You know, he made it to the Team USA to the Olympics.
Yeah, he was telling me. He won the Olympic trials.
Jose was on the USA team in London.
Yeah, I know. What year?
2012. I interviewed him out there. Yeah. He was the most normal. Well, I shouldn't say that. There were a lot of good dudes on the team, but he was the most approachable.
What was that, London?
Yeah. It was a great experience. He had
the polo suit?
The polo suit, yeah.
Hey.
Yeah.
Do you want to hear the crazy shit? He had McDonald's cups with his face on it. McDonald's.
Yeah, McDonald's sponsored me, yeah.
Oh, yeah?
That's big time. Do you eat McDonald's?
They
get behind a... Yeah. I go and get like a McFrappe or some shit, like an ice cream.
Oh, like my name is Sparky too, right?
Yeah. No, like Kobe Bryant, him.
Cola got her.
Cola, where?
Yeah, Cola, yeah.
That's crazy.
Yeah. You got to meet Kobe, right?
Yeah, man, we were in the opening ceremony, you know, closing ceremony together. So, Michael Phelps, LeBron James, Anthony Davis, a lot of talent. Westbrook.
Anthony Davis was a rookie because I remember walking around London.
Yeah, he got signed and they chose him to go to the.
I was walking around London. No one knew who he was. He was walking around by himself.
Yeah, he was. He had just got picked up to the NBA in the draft. I think he played in the Olympics before he played one professional game at the.
That's true.
I believe, I think.
No, that's true. Back then they had two.
So they chose him to, you know, to be an Olympic. Yeah. He had just gotten drafted. He was number one draft pick.
Yeah.
He came out of Duke, right?
Where did he fight? I'm not sure. Was it Duke?
Where?
I've seen him at Goosen Gym a few times.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, very nice guy. This week you're cutting weight. You look on weight though.
No, I'm
saying you look like 47, 48.
I'm 46.
I'm 46?
I'm trying to get to that weight.
46.2.
So no, you'll get there. You have 12 days.
No, I'm good. I'm good.
It's not fun cutting weight. Nobody likes it.
I lost the last couple pounds last week.
Does Charles help you with the cutting weight?
Yeah, of course.
Charles, do you cook for him too or no?
I have a little bit, but Marisol, you know, his girl cooks great.
She knows.
She knows what to do after all these years, and she's a really good cook. So it's not just a, you know, it's much easier to eat less food when it tastes good too. Yeah. And more satisfied.
Well, something you told me, that when you're in good shape, you don't eat that much. You don't overeat because your body's good.
Well, you have all the nutrients you need in food. You can eat a lot of food and still be hungry because your body's starving for nutrients, you know? It's still signaling it needs something.
How's Mikey doing?
Good.
Yeah.
He might fight Pacquiao.
Maybe.
It's a big fight.
It'll be a good fight.
I hope it happens.
I know he's going to be, you know, we have a lot of time to work, so I know he's going to be in tremendous shape and maybe the strongest you've ever seen him.
I saw he's doing some tough drills. Not easy, Charles. It's not. He doesn't just come and stretch and jump rope.
Can't jog and swim and
hey, elite. Alexis Espino hits very, very hard. After working with you, how hard do you think you will hit?
He's gonna continue to improve and get better. He's also young, so he has so much room for improvement. He's not even near his peak yet. He's gonna be an absolute monster, you know?
So the Charles work, I feel like you're gonna grow agile on this to like, I feel like to like not be so planted on the floor too. You can come at somebody, you know, like Jose Ramirez, and still knock him out on your move.
He's gonna probably catch a case for manslaughter in the ring one day, but
I hope not. I hope not.
Oh yeah, man, he's strong.
He's like a bull.
I haven't sparred him, but man, he's strong.
No, he's very hard. In the amateurs, he had like eight fights? And he fought a guy that had like 176 fights with like 3 losses, and he dropped him. 6 fights? 6 fights. That, you hit hard. Naturally. It was a good fight. No, but I'm saying, listen, if you have 200 fights, and you're fighting a guy with 6 fights, and he could drop you, he just hits very, very hard. Jose, he had a very short amateur career. What, 20 fights?
Yeah, 25 fights.
How many amateur fights have you had? A few hundred?
160.
How many did you win?
I lost like 20.
How many amateur fights?
Man, it's hard for me to say, to be honest, Ellie, but I had close to 200.
And what did you win? Like 190 or something?
Since like, I lost someone else because I started when I was 8. So I lost like 1-2 fights a year, all the way until I was like, 13 years old.
But not all the losses were losses, because I know amateur boxing. It's politics a lot.
Well, I was 8 years old too. Fighting a guy, I was 9 or 9. You know, I had.
Yeah, no, those
fights,
early ones, you know, that's boxing. But I'm saying later on.
Since I turned 15 and started competing in the nationals, I only lost once in the United States.
Wow. Who's the one guy you lost to?
Eric DeLeon.
Eric DeLeon, the train's here?
Yeah.
The Southpaw?
Yeah.
He's a very good boxer.
Golden Gloves.
Yeah. I always think he's Puerto Rican.
It was the first year in the Golden Gloves that I went to, but
so. You're out?
Yeah.
Hey, everybody who fights Pacquiao, they spar him.
Yeah, I spar him. But then I went on, the same year we went on to the Olympic Trials, and I won the Olympic Trials.
That's badass. Who was the biggest name you faced there?
No, he lost twice to 2 different fighters. He lost to Manuel Williams, and he lost to Kenny Sims. So and I beat both of those guys.
I've seen you fight Kenny Sims.
Yeah, I beat him.
Kenny's very talented.
I beat him 3 times. I beat right now. Twice.
I don't really
fight.
And I beat
right now Williams twice.
Well, what was it? Alabama.
Alabama.
I was there.
Yeah, I won.
You were there?
I was there.
How old were you?
I was in the jails. They were having the
They had the jails and the U.S. Men's Open.
That's together. Cool. So you can see the future stars.
So I won the U.S. That whole tournament, and I won every single U.S. men's nationals. So I'm not talking about the silver gloves, I'm not talking about the
nationals.
I won those nationals too. But national championships, like the U.S. men's, which is probably the biggest, because that's the only one that pays you monthly stipend, and that makes you like represent the Team USA.
Jose, what's a monthly stipend from Team USA? That's nothing. That doesn't pay rent, that barely covers food.
17 years old, $1,000.
That's still not money. I mean, in this economy, what can you do with $1,000? Rent a room in a house and not eat?
Yeah, I mean, 10 years ago.
That's why he's turning pro, even though he could be an Olympian. Because he has to eat.
Yeah, so, yeah, you're right. Because the European team, or the Great Britain team, they were getting paid, I think, 5,000 pounds a month.
That's real money.
5,000 pounds.
In Mexico, too, Carlos Slim donated a lot of money to the Olympians. He pays for the hotel, the expenses.
Yeah.
So you should have been a Mexican Olympian. You would have killed it.
I wanted to, man.
Too late now. Well, not too late, because they asked Andy Ruiz. Hey, the Mexican team asked Andy Ruiz to go to the Olympics and represent him.
I
told him he should have gone to Mexico. Carlos Slim would have paid him.
That would have been Russian. Nice.
Yeah, he looks like Ivan Redcatch. Milwaukee made 1995. Make sure to follow him. Marcus Valle is about to turn pro. He's sparring Jose Ramirez. He's playing the part of Postol. Have you studied Postol to move like him, throw punches like him?
I just do what I do, and then they kind of tell me things to do too, you know, like.
Yeah.
Because they have obviously seen, you know, him fight and all that, but so I've only seen like two fights of this.
You're going to be the first Puerto Rican champion in this gym.
Yeah,
stay tuned, guys. 10 fights. I say 12 fights, he wins the title. He's tall, he's strong, he's good to go. Robert, is Hector Tanahara fighting Fortuna?
No, two ago.
No, someone was asking me.
No, he's not fighting Fortuna.
Does he have any fight?
No, not right now. Not right
he's
now.
Looking for something. It's so hot in here. It's so hot in here, Leo. It's like the heater's on.
Yeah.
Leo Ruiz
is
in the
heater on?
No, it's light.
Oh, shit.
My phone turned off from the heat.
Oh, yeah. I feel like it. I barely started shutting off.
Is it hot like this in Florida?
It's humid in Florida.
Yeah, it is. I know. It's like, well, I changed 5 shirts.
Right.
Like Panama, too. Same thing.
Yeah. It's a different temperature here.
Look out for Leo. Leo, what's the record now?
7-0 with 5 knockouts.
That's badass. Keep it going.
Yes, sir.
When are you fighting? Do you know?
I think September 5th. The top rank card.
That's badass.
Yeah.
He sparred Mikey. He sparred Jose Ramirez. He sparred everybody. Jose Cito Lopez. Very talented fighter. Where are you from?
I was born in Mexico, in Zacatecas. And I was brought over here, and I was raised in San Bernardino.
San Bernardino in the house.
Yeah.
Ruben Rodriguez and his brother Baby. Ruben, how are you feeling?
Good.
Yeah. What are you going to do today?
Get a couple rounds in with Jose, help him close the week.
It is hot. It's like the heater's on. That's how hot it is. My phone died already twice from the heat.
It's hotter in India.
Have you been to India lately?
I live in India.
It's like 137 degrees in India.
120, 121.
That is crazy.
At night, it's like the sun's down and everything. It's 115.
How do you live like that?
Inside.
That's like punishment. I'm gonna ask Robert. Jose, you know how hot is it in India right now? 120 degrees. That's ugly. Yeah, that's where. That is bad. What's your prediction for Jose Ramirez, Victor Postol?
He's going down.
What round?
Ooh, I don't know. Jose's going to give it his best. He'll come out victorious, however it works out for him. That's what I know.
The W, that's it. Just the
W. You make the change, man. You know, no opponent's easy.
That's true.
No. The hardest opponent in life is life. Life always keeps punching.
Life's undefeated.
Yeah, life's undefeated. All the time.
You came to support him today? You came to watch him spar?
Yeah. I've known Jose for 3 or 4 years now. He's a good man.
He is. I've seen you at his fights.
Yeah.
In Fresno.
My birthday's the 29th this week, so I'm having a big party. I got 60 people coming over. You're going to have all the... Anyways, we're going to have it there on the 29th. Those I'd be in Vegas.
Early happy birthday.
So I go, thank you.
Yeah, no fans.
I mentioned you last time. You're some blogger or something like that.
That's me.
I am the Almond Man, so follow me on Instagram.
I remember.
I got a podcast now.
What is it?
I am the Almond Man podcast.
That's it. I remember you came with the private jet. That's all I remember.
I still got it.
That's badass. Hey, Jose. Jose, how can I get a private jet like the Almond Man? What do I need to do?
Buy some almonds. Plant some almond trees. That's all you need to do.
If it was that easy, anyone would do it. It's not easy.
That's why I got in the business with only 6,000 competitors. I just need to be better than 5,995.
Now, how did you do it?
My pappy, my dad taught me.
Because almonds, look, they have almond milk, they use almond for cooking, your almond roasting, there's so much you could do with almonds.
Here's how it happened, I'll tell you. I was born into business.
Uh-huh.
80% of the world's almonds are grown in California, so I don't compete against other worlds. And that's because I just got very lucky. I'm not a very smart man, I'm humble, and I'm so happy to have friends like this, to meet guys like you,
hey,
stuff like that.
Hard work beats talent when talent doesn't work hard.
Not all bulls can be longhorns either.
That's true. That's good, but it's nice of you to come support because it always lifts the spirit. When a new face is here, it's motivation because you see the same faces all the time and it gets kind of like, this is his third camp for the same opponent.
I know. That's hard to deal with too. No people in the stands, no people. That's
correct.
Pretty interesting.
Yeah, you can hear everything.
The beer line shouldn't be too long.
Well, the casino will probably sell beer.
So what's your name again?
Elie.
Elie. Do you have Instagram too?
Yes.
Oh.
Hold on, here.
I want to follow you.
Yeah, here. Follow me and I'll follow you back. Here.
I don't know. You send me a message. How about that? I am the Almond Man. I'm not
okay.
That stuff.
What is it?
I am the Almond Man.
I just found you like that.
There you go.
You have a lot of followers. You're popular.
No, I dated some girl. She said she could buy 5,000. I didn't believe her.
No.
I buy a Rolex watch.
That's funny. Here, I'll say it.
What's the truth? I didn't know what I'm doing.
But that's the best way. You learn by experience. Yeah, so I just followed you. This is my page here.
Right on, dude.
No, I'll get you back. I'm having fun. Listen, life is short. You got to do what you enjoy.
I think last time I saw you was about 2 years ago.
Yep. In Fresno, I think.
No, it was here. You were filming here.
Yeah,
you're
I remember
from
yeah,
LA
yeah,
or somewhere.
That's true.
You're
yep.
from LA, right?
Yes, that's
yeah,
true. You have a good memory.
No, I don't. I do bake too much.
But no, it's good. It's just we live in a Twilight Zone world right now, unfortunately. Everything's weird, but 6 more months, 8 more months, I think we'll be okay.
Might be longer.
Google and TV stations.
I hope you're right. My hope is like 2 days.
No, it's probably a year. Okay. Thank you. Oh, that's very nice.
Go, Jose.
Oh, that's
sick. How about everyone this when he's going to fight in Fresno? And he got to do this.
These nuts. I like that. These nuts. You should have been next shirt. These nuts.
Sure. There you go.
Oh, that's cool. Thank you so much.
You have children?
Not yet. One on the way, but we'll wait before we get one.
Oh, shit.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Elie Seckbach.